Welcome to video number 3 on understanding the Amazon suspension email. So today I'm picking up the category called intellectual property complaints. What are intellectual property complaints? You get a notice from Amazon that your listing has been removed because of your product is violating somebody else's intellectual property. Now, to understand IPC well, you need to read about trademark law or the copyright law. So intellectual property complaints can be of varied reasons. To know intellectual property complaints better, it is advised that you should take learning about trademark law, copyright law, or if you're slapped with an IPC suspension notice, please understand IPC is not a regular suspension. It's a completely different suspension. And you may not be taking help from the regular people who are generating just a POA, because somebody who has a knowledge of writing to the brand, which have given you the complaint of violating the intellectual property is important here. So I'm going to open two emails in front of you. Two emails, both are categorized under the IPC violation, intellectual property complaint violation. They have been filed for different reasons. So I'm going to pick up reason by reason both the mails so that you can well understand in case ever if you slap with an IPC suspension notice. Also, to make it very clear to you, many a times brand who are themselves selling on Amazon just to restrict the competition may file this kind of a complaint. And every complaint which comes in needs to be verified in details. And I always say that every seller has got their unique problem. So never ever pick up any Google templates and start or build your own POAs. No, never ever trust anybody who is just making a random draft for you, because your problem is unique. Your solution has to be unique. So I'm going to share two different IPC complaint heads with you in this particular video today. And if you're learning, just give a thumbs up to this particular video. There are two more videos which were recorded earlier. That was regarding the suspected intellectual email, and the other one as sold, used as new category. So in case you missed those videos, it's there, right? You will find somewhere around the video. You can watch those videos which have been recorded earlier. This is the series number. This is video number 3 of the particular series on Amazon Plan of Action. So today I'm going to open up my screen. I'll show you case number 1 and I'll show you case number 2. I'll tell you what is the difference and how to generate an effective plan of action, how to really remove this particular complaint and save your account from suspension in case, because most of the cases in IPC first, you will only get listing suspension. That's the first thing you do. And if you successfully appeal that, you can save your account from suspension. In case you are already suspended, you need to follow whatever we are discussing now, even in a better detail. So let me just start sharing my screen. So here I'm picking the first case. Here I'm picking the first case. This is a case which I handled some time back related to intellectual property complaint. Let's understand this particular email. This particular email says, we received a report from the rights owner that product listed at the end of this mail are inauthentic. The moment you read this, end of this mail are inauthentic, that means the brand thinks that you are selling a product which may not be the right product. You're selling a fake product of the same brand. This is what the brand is thinking, and this is why you got the complaint. Now, why this is happening? Most likely the brand does not want to entertain any resellers on the same listing. They're happy with the selling of their own brand. They don't want any other people to really list their product. Although there is no crime of reselling a product. If let's take an example of any grocery or any whatever example you wanted to pick up, any TV or anything you want to pick up, whatever is available in the retail market, whatever is available openly in the retail market, you can buy that product and you can list that product unless and until they are gated with Amazon. Like, you cannot list Apple products, you cannot list Samsung, you cannot list Xiaomi. So there are many brands which you cannot list. They are gated brands. So there is a list of gated brands. You can just find Google and you will find the list of gated brands. You can check with seller support team also in case you want to check that this brand is gated or not. But other than that, which brands are not gated, there is no law as for the, you know, law of land or whatever country you are in, even if you're in US also, there's no law. In US, there is a first sale doctrine also which applies. So any which ways, there is no crime of reselling. But now the manufacturer does not want you to really resell. They have put you in a situation where account is at the risk of suspension or maybe suspended already. How to tackle this particular case? How to tackle particular this complaint? So yes, you need to send a proper POA also as such for this particular case. What else you want to do is it says inauthentic. So the best way of tackling this particular issue right now, what you can see on your screen, is to reach out to the complainant. So you will find somewhere here, these are the right contact owner details. So there's a name or email ID which is given to you. Write an email to that particular brand. Tell about that, okay, that you are selling from, since this is date you're already selling, how you procured your item. Show them, give them your invoices that this is how we are buying and we are selling the authentic products and everything. And as you now know that the brand does not want you to really sell this product, you can tell that, okay, fine, now I'll not be selling the same product because it's like you don't want that to happen. But at the same time, as my products are authentic, please send a retraction email. Now, while you request the brand to send a retraction email, you need to ensure two things to it. The email should go directly to notice-dispute@amazon.in from the same email ID through which the this particular IPC complaint was registered. This is one important thing, that if it is generated from x@apple.com, it should go from x@apple.com. It should not go from y@apple.com. You just have to take care of that thing. One. Secondly, because you will not have any visibility if they have mailed it or not, just request the complainant to mark a CC to you. So two has to be Amazon, the notice dispute team. CC has to be you. This is the best way of getting rid of this particular problem. And after that, you can simply create your POA, mentioning the root cause, why this has happened, what actions you have taken, already listing the deleting, listing has been deleted, you got your retraction done, and your future action plan that similar situation will not arise in the future also. And you can get this complaint settled. This is only when you're getting an IPC complaint as inauthentic. Now there's another version of IPC complaint, and let me just share another email with you. Let's come to the case number two now. On your screen, there is a case number two. Now the case number two is a bit different here. It says, we have removed some of your listing because we received a report from the rights owner that they infringe the following trademark. And there's a trademark number which is given. Now, to handle this particular complaint, you need somebody who can guide you about trademark law, about, you know, that you are violating a trademark here. So basis on the trademark violation, there are certain conditions, the law, the entire trademark act is there. As per the act, you need to understand this mark is for what particular reason. Is it protecting the list? Is it protecting the image? It is protecting the product. What exactly is the trademark for? Based on that, you need to understand what violation you did. Based on the violation you did, you will have to identify that. You have to take corrective measure in terms of, suppose you have violated the image. Suppose it's not trademark, it might also come as a copyright. It might say that infringing the rights, like in infringing the rights in an image. So might not copyright, you might get that image is getting infringed. You might get that also. So whatever is the infringement, trademark, image, content, suppose you have just copy pasted the content from a brand and listed on your own selling page, that's also a violation. You picked up a random image from Google, you paste it in front of your product image, that's also a violation. You have not taken consent from the image owner to use the image for your listing. So you need to very, very understand the whole concept of trademark law for yourself. You can take help from any attorney, or if you want help from me, I'll also guide you on that matter. I also make these POAs because you need to be well versed with the respective laws which govern the trademark and copyright violations. Okay. In case you want to know how to safeguard your images, suppose you are into creating certain images for your product and you feel it might be copied and all that stuff, you can simply register for the DMCA service. The link is given in the description box. DMCA is Digital Millennium Copyright Act, and you will be able to safeguard your all images, all your content. They charge you a nominal fees of $10 a month. So at $10 a month, you can really save a lot of your reputation, which is there on the online. Now, coming back to the plan of action thing, in this particular case also, you need to reach out to the rights owner. You need to tell them that why you have violated the rights. Is it the right thing or wrong thing or whatever? Like, I give an example. Apple is, we all know Apple iPhone is a brand. But Apple also is a fruit. In case you are writing in your listing four boxes of apple juice, it's also apple. It's not a trademark violation. If you know what trademark act, you know what I'm talking about. This apple is not violating the rights of that apple. Both are same name, apple, apple. The names are same. But trademark law has got very clear-cut distinction between the same name is depicting your product, not their product, is not a violation. If you are using a part of the image to make your full picture of your own listing and your own sales page, to an extent, this also can be safeguarded. This also cannot be termed as a violation. Only and only if explicitly you are gaining benefit, that you are selling some product which may not be compatible with Apple, or which may be compatible with Apple but not approved by them, and you're using that image, half-cut Apple of image, you're using it and placing it in your sales page, you are deliberately disrupting the brand, you are using that brand for your personal gains. This is a complete violation under the Copyright Act or the Trademark Act. So you need to be very, very careful that you receive. Either you will receive inauthentic one, or you will receive the copyright or the trademark. So copyright and trademark, in both the cases, you need to understand these both the two important laws, the Copyright Act and the trademark law. Just understand those laws, take help from any of your attorney if you knows, it will really going to help you with that. The best way of handling these two complaints always, let me just stop sharing my screen now. Yeah, so you have seen two examples, right? So the best way is to reach out to the rights owner. For inauthentic, you will not still have much of problem, because in that case, you need to really get back to them with your invoices, purchase invoices and everything, how the listing was created, when did you started selling on. You need to prove to Amazon that you are selling a genuine product and not a fake product, and you can counter that well in your POA. Coming to the violation, the trademark law violation or the copyright violation, trademark happens to be mostly in the names and the packaging and everything. There the trademark violation comes into the picture. Copyright majorly comes into the image and the content part of it. Both the things you need to understand. In whatever country you are operating in, India, US, UK, your country has their own trademark laws and copyright laws. Just understand those laws. Just see where the violation has happened. Take corrective measure, reach out to the brand, tell them that this corrective measure you have already taken now, this will not be repeated again. Request them for a retraction, that's the best way of doing it. In case the brand is not cooperating with that matter, then you need to write a better draft, a better POA. You can take help from any attorney who can give you some more insights about, on his own letterhead, he can write about that, yes, this is a violation here and here, and this is what the action seller has taken. So, considering that the brand is not responding up, his request may be considered and he may be allowed to sell again. So you need to very understand the whole concept. You know, it is not a game of just, violating it and you will get your account back. It's not that easy. IPC violation are very, very stringent, because IPC is a part of the DMCA Act itself. So Amazon is a marketplace. ISPs, as you know, whatever ISPs are using, they are all exempted from the copywriting. Although, you know, you might like to answer this, that it is hosted on Amazon, so Amazon should be a party to that. Why Amazon has allowed it? See, Amazon as a marketplace allows sellers and buyers to interact at a marketplace. At the same time, when the digital agreement they do with you, you take the responsibility that you will not be placing any right which is violating anybody else's rights. And with the you know, the digital protections available to every brand, you can also use the same. The link is in the description box below in case you want to safeguard your images and content. Sign up for that service, $10 a month. You will have a lot of peace coming into your life. Because automatic detections will come. Automatic detections, you will get to know that somebody is using your image, and you can use the templates which are available in the portal and send that complaint to the respective marketplace. Similar way, they will also receive a complaint. So I hope I'm able to give you some insights about this particular violation. IPC violation is intellectual property rights violation. Can be happened if the seller, if the manufacturer or the, you know, whosoever is complaining to you, who's the rights owner, believes that you are selling fake products, you will get an IPC complaint. If you are violating somebody else's trademark using their own name, which is not their product, but similar looking product, and you are selling it without whatever, you know, there's a product, you are also selling the similar product, but your product is not the same product what that has been listed, because that is their product and they are not allowed you to sell. So you're violating the trademark. So in case you are using their packaging, copying their packaging, using the trademark in your own papers and all that, so these are all violations of trademark. Similarly, copyright violations is again the same thing. Images, you are using somebody else's images without their permission. You are copying the content, plagiarism. They all are violations under IPC. So copyright, trademark, inauthenticity, all kind of complaints you are going to receive in case you are hit with IPC complaint. So these are the way you need to understand what the mail is telling you, what action you want to take. You need to send a plan of action along with the retraction. Retraction is the best way of getting it done. Approach anybody. If you want to reach out to me, reach out to me. The link is in the description box. How I can help you with IPC is a different ball game altogether. Cannot be done by everybody. When you send it to me, because I have been reading all these laws and everything, then that is why I'm able to, you know, cover up. At some point in time, even I will tell you that from this point on, I need some lawyer friend of yours so that he can give me this kind of a draft on his letterhead. But drafting can happen, but something which is required in a legal language has to come from a lawyer. So just to give you more insights about the IPC violation. IPC violations are critical in nature, directly going to impact you, chop off your listing, chop off your account also. The best way is to get a retraction done. Reach out to the brand with the facts. Take help from somebody who can write the email to be sent to the brand in a particular format. And this is the way you can really get out of the situation you are in as far as the IPC complaint is concerned. So I believe you got some learning. You have some idea about the IPC complaints. In case you're liking this series, I want you to give a thumbs up. I want you to share this particular video. I want you to subscribe this channel. Share it with more and more people, this particular knowledge. I'm going to cover all the suspension email which comes for whatever type and subtypes and everything. So now I'll meet you in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.